Okay, I make it exactly a quarter after. Thank you all so much for being here. My name is Glenn Taylor, and I'm going to be performing all original material here today. Some of it is off an album I did in 2014, a self-released album called Tearing to the Future. It was all fully instrumented and all of that. And some of it, some of these are brand new and or recent pieces. So, hope you enjoy. Thank you for spending your lunch here. This first one is one of the new ones that's yet to be recorded, and it's called Not Much of a Prayer.
Show your raw conviction, or come sing your lethal creed. This is not a place for a gentle soul to dream. Now the truth works for a fiction, you'll never break the alpha breeze. You're gonna let them go, stay low, and bring your own life up to speed. Build your brand of mirror, make your sound, and claim your space. You get no return on a quiet heart of stone. They're all born to be converted, oh, but they all just know their place. Up in the infinite shade, I can see what you've made. It's got your pretty face. It's strange to us who have no scheme, for the world revolves around our dreams. So busy we with all our own repairs. We're only here until it ends, when what will be becomes what's been. We'll go from there. I know it's not much of a prayer. We're grateful to our
Thank you very much. This is another new one, a recent one, called, what is it called? It's called Over Again. Song. I'm not quite sure to whom or This one is very recent. Just kind of finished it once we got here, came here in September from the United States, and just lovely to be in England and feel like the most fortunate man in the world to be pursuing my PhD at the University of New York. The fact that I'm doing this as well, I think it's just beyond my ability to comprehend. Anyway, this is called Behind Me.
Love.
is on the album Turning to the Future, and this is a song that it's called A New Love Already Gone Away, and it's about it's kind of about a town called Madison, Wisconsin, which is in the American kind of eastern Midwest state of Wisconsin. It's about 30 miles just due west of Milwaukee, which is on the western shore of Michigan. Madison is a kind of world famous college town along the lines of, you know, Berkeley, California, or Ann Arbor, Michigan. And it's also, it used to be a place where, like so many college towns in the United States, that not only college students live there, but kind of itinerant people not in college traveling around doing music and stuff like me would wind up in these places as well. Although, I must say that being, at least in the United States, in a town that, unlike, for example, York, which is kind of a town in its own right, it's got its own thing going on other than the University of York, in a town like Madison or Ann Arbor, where most of it has everything to do with the university, also the state capital, in Madison, being there and not being a student can be insanely lonely, and even if you're doing things because you're outside of this whole kind of routine and process. And so it's really strange when you kind of, you know, are sort of involved in things, but not really. You know, you hang out with these people, you do things with them, you perform for them, you perform with them, but then at the end of the day, it's this really odd thing where everybody just kind of goes their separate ways. And this is kind of about that kind of strangeness.
She asked me, where are you?
This next one is a recent one as well. And actually, it makes sense that a lot of these are not on the album, but the album, as I said, with the exception of one song, is fully instrumented. It's actually very difficult sometimes to translate those to solo performances. So the stuff I've been doing recently, because it's just been guitar and piano, kind of turns out to be more solo oriented, so it all works out. But if you would like to hear the album, it's like everything these days, it's online. It's a risk-free endeavor. If you want to dial up Tear Into the Future and give it a listen, please do. And when you do that, you will not hear this song, which is called Thin Air. This is another very recent one. And I've actually played this before for people. In this particular one, I was asked what exactly it's about. And I would say that all of these songs, with the exception of the rare song that I wanted to just play about, it's kind of about something. After a long time, these things tend to be about a lot of things. And I find that when you're writing about kind of bilious relatives or whatever, in-laws, you write this song and you play through it and you realize you've just written about the world political situation, like writing about your, and vice versa, right? And so there are so many things that go into, as many of you probably have experienced yourself, go into these things, but somewhere they must have a focus. And this one is called Thin Air. Thank you.
is so gotten old. I want to take your hand in the greenest field of clover, my love. And I'm worried about a future that's been stolen and resold.
And everybody running this up here. Absolutely fantastic. Thank you all very much.